Hello, in this video I'll show you how to perform Raritan intelligent PDU backups from the command line. Now when we do a backup, we normally do it through the web interface by going to maintenance, backup and restore, and we click on the download device settings. Browser will ask us where we want to put the file. I'll just say save the file. The file has been saved. And if I have a look in my downloads folder, we've got a file called backup settings with today's date. And if I open that up with Notepad, there's our backup. So one of the things that you might not realize is that you can do the backups from the command line. So I'm on a Linux box in a directory called backups, which is currently empty. And what I can do is I can use the secure copy command. Specify the admin user, the PX2 study, the name of the intelligent PDU, and then this special file, backup_settings.txt, and I'll copy it into my current directory. It asks me for the admin password. After a short while, we've got a file called backup settings, and if we have a look at that file, there we go, we've got our backup. Now you can use a different user, so I can achieve the same result using my login ID AndyC. So let me just get rid of that backup settings file and let's issue the same command, but this time use user AndyC. Now we get asked my password, which I will put in. And we get exactly the same result. Now, because I've got a secure shell key set up on my box here, if I copy my public key, which is this, onto the PDU, under my user settings, so let's go to home, user management, edit the settings for user AndyC, which is me, and we can see that currently I don't have a SSH public key. Let me paste in my public key there. Let me go and save. Successfully save. Now go back to my backups directory, remove the backup file, just to prove that it's actually working, and then run the SCP command again using user AndyC. And this time, because I've got a public key set up, it doesn't ask me for a password. And lo and behold, there's the backup settings. Now, because you can now do the backup from the command line without having to specify a password because we're using secure shell access, we can write a shell script very simple one. I've just written my here called PDU backups, and what it's going to do is it's going to go and back up four PDUs which I've got named here using the user AndyC, and it will just go through and it will basically run that SCP command, but instead of just putting the file into the current directory, it'll give it a name with the name of the PDU. If we run it, we'll see that in action. So first of all, it's going to log into the PX2 Brent and Derwent. If you watch any of my videos and you see all these weird names, they're actually names of rivers in the UK. That's doing the fourth one now. So that's finished. And there we go. We've got the four backup settings for each of those PDUs. Let's just look at one of them just to show you. There we go. So that's how we can automate that process. And because that's a very simple shell script, we could automate, we could put that into a Unix Linux cron job and have that run automatically every night. So you'd always have a nice recent up-to-date backup of your PDUs. And if you've got hundreds or thousands of PDUs, this is the basis of a very good solution to do that. Certainly a lot faster than logging in to the web interface on all of those PDUs and basically taking a backup manually and then having to copy the file out of your downloads file. So I think you get the idea. Now, for those of you who are thinking, well, I'm more at home on Microsoft, on Windows, well, if you download the PSCP command, which is related to the PuTTY command, we can run a similar command. I'll just show you currently there. We've only got these four files, so my public and private keys. So PSCP, we do it in, I specify the name of my private key here. Then we carry on in a very similar way. And you see at px2.study colon backup underscore settings.txt and then we'll call it backup settings.txt locally. Run that. Does a very similar thing now. Now we've got that file there, and if we open it up in Notepad, there we go, and we've got the backup file there. As for writing a script under Windows, you could maybe put a batch file together, or if you're into PowerShell, you could put something together simply there. But you've got the very basic commands which you need there to perform the actual backups. So performing backups of your Raritan PDUs is important to have up-to-date copies of the configurations in the event that the configurations get corrupted or a PDU is lost through hardware failure and you need to replace it and get the last known good configuration back up and running nice and quickly. Anyway, that's how to do it. That's a little short video showing you how to do it. Thank you for watching, as always.